In the summer of 2018, Americans heading overseas to Europe had their pick of airlines ranging from the cheapest low-cost carrier to the most expensive premium carrier. Low-cost transatlantic carriers like WOW Air, Primera Air, and Norwegian Air Shuttle offered inexpensive fares that opened up Europe to more travelers and lowered fares across the board. That was until those airlines started disappearing one by one, starting with Primera in October 2018, WOW in March 2019, and Norwegian, at least from the transatlantic market, in March 2020. But the summer of vaccinated travel is seeing the return of two transatlantic airlines aiming to make it easier and cheaper to access Europe once again as the continent reopens to Americans. Low-cost leisure airline French Bee is returning to the US on July 15th with a brand new route between Newark and Paris, France. It's the carrier's second U.S. route behind Paris-San Francisco, which remains temporarily suspended. We think the crisis is behind us because of the vaccination process all over the world, Marc Richer, French Bee's chief executive officer, told Insider. The European people cannot travel without any constraint to the U.S., but we think it's time to move on. European tourists still can't enter the U.S. under travel restrictions dating back to March 2020. But Richer says there's enough demand from American tourists and from the cargo industry to offer the flights, noting that the airline is successfully filling its planes with cargo to help offset passenger revenues. Operating the service will be French Bee's flagship Airbus A350-900XWB plane with economy and premium economy seating. The Backstreet Boys are planning a Christmas-themed Las Vegas residency. Here's how to get a spot on a Virgin Galactic space flight if you don't have $250,000. Giant pandas taken off China's endangered species list. Disney's newest cruise ship will feature an epic Marvel themed dining experience. You can now get directions from a cat or a dog on Waze. This brand new hotel in Italy is home to the world's first truffle concierge. June 2021 broke records as the hottest June on record in the US. Virgin Galactic's successful test flight, with Richard Branson on board, brings us one step closer to space tourism. LAX is about to open what may be the most luxurious lounge a US airport has ever seen. Rooms at the Surf Lodge in Montauk have a beauty minibar you need to know about. Nick's first major LGBTQ+ museum is coming, and the events have already begun. Whiskey brand Uncle Nearest reopened their Tennessee distillery. New York's outdoor dining plan extended for another year. Virgin Voyages delays debut of second ship to 2022 and cancels more sailings. Get free museum tickets across the U.S. in September to celebrate Smithsonian's annual Museum Day. The best time to visit Las Vegas for good prices and fewer crowds. In flight amenities vary based on the purchased fare. The very lowest fare, called basic, only includes a ticket to ride, a carry-on bag, and a personal item, while extras like meals, advanced seat assignments, and checked baggage costs extra. La Compagnie has also resumed flying between the US and France with its first flight on June 17 between Newark and Paris. Unlike French Bee, however, the boutique airline is appealing to premium leisure travelers with an all-business class offering, albeit at a lower price than traditional carriers. Two routes are currently offered between Newark and the French cities of Paris and Nice. New routes to Milan, Italy and Tel Aviv, Israel will be added this year from Newark with a layover in Paris. We think we are on the right market demand at the right moment, Richer said. France has reopened to all Americans, vaccinated and unvaccinated, the latter with proof of a negative test, and tourists have been flocking overseas as a result. As to whether the French people will be as eager to go abroad as Americans were when travel restrictions lifted, Richer's guiding principle is that everybody in their lives wants to see, one day, New York. I think there is a strong demand today waiting in France for many people, Richer said. Young ones, families want to get out of this crisis. They want to travel, and New York is at the top of their list. Thank you.